Hello and welcome to Accounting After Dark, or how we help out my former students who are dying and yelling at me in intermediate accounting at certain universities that are close to my where I teach. So today we're going to be working on exercise 4-8 of the KISO 17th edition. This video is unlisted because the publisher will not allow me to make public videos. So if you have the link, you're in for a treat. So a couple different things right here. We're being asked to compute net income and then also preparing a partial income statement with income from continuing operations and including appropriate earnings per share information. Okay. So a couple things here is that with these questions, if we're doing an income statement, we don't need cash. Okay, we don't need cash dividends declared, cash dividends paid. Depreciation expense not recorded in 2019 and retained earnings, this is kind of irrelevant to us. And we would not record unrecorded depreciation expense in 2020 because these ledger accounts, this is for net income for 2020. So we're not going to be using this depreciation expense because we would show that as a prior period adjustment to retained earnings. If I was to do this question, what I would do is that if I was asked to do a statement of retained earnings, I would show this is my beginning. I would then show this prior period adjustment here, net of tax. So one of the things we have to remind ourselves is that when we're going through and dealing with discontinued operations, we have to show this separately from our continuing operations. And this is really to make sure that our financial statements have what it is called comparability. Please look at my other unlisted video concerning the financial tree of accounting to take a look at that one. So let's go ahead and start kind of going through this question here. So I've got net sales of $540,000. Okay, less my expenses. Now, we're gonna go ahead and do this as a single step income statement. So over here, I have, let's just go down the list. Administrative expenses, selling expenses, cost of goods sold. So over here, this is 100,000. This is 80,000. This over here is 210,000. Then I get over here. Now, I'm not going to include discontinued operations in this because this is not from continuing operations, right? These items signify what I'm actually making in my current business right now. So my total expenses here are going to be $390,000. So my net income before income taxes is going to be $540,000 minus $390,000 or $150,000, okay? Less my income taxes is gonna be over here. This is gonna be $150,000 times 20%. And now I'm gonna get to my net income after tax before discontinued operations. So this is going to be $120,000. Now, the next thing that I see here, so this is my operating income. Then over here, what I need to go through and do is I need to go through and say, hey, what about discontinued operations? So notice here the wording. This is the loss before income taxes of $40,000. Because I'm showing this below net income after tax, I need to show this amount net of tax. What does that mean? I have to net out the number in terms of taking out that tax amount. So I'm gonna say less discontinued operations. And again, because this number is net of tax, it's 150,000 minus 30,000 or 120. So what I have to do here is I have to say, well, 40,000, which was my loss before income taxes, less 40,000 times 20% or 8,000 is going to give me 32,000. So my discontinued operations is going to be less 32,000. So now what I'm getting is I'm now getting my net income total basically over here of 88,000. Now, the next thing I'm asked to go through and do, so remember again, it's very important with discounted, wow, look at that spelling job, Tchaikovsky. Wow, that's really nice and crappy. Okay, continued operations. So now I'm down here at net income, and I'm looking at this 88 grand. It's like, okay, this is great. Now, when it comes to earnings per share, what I have to make sure that I go through and do is I need to show this kind of special, okay? And the way I need to show this kind of special is because I need to show my earnings per share over here before the discontinued operations, less that adjustment for over here, and then going over here to my net income, you know, basically, which is after the loss from the discontinued operations. So my earnings per share, the way I'm gonna figure this out is, remember, what is earnings per share? It's gonna be net income, right? Minus any kind of preferred dividends, but we don't have that yet, divided by my average shares outstanding. So what I'm gonna do here is I'm gonna kind of say, well, my net income, right? Or I can kind of say over here, my net income after tax, but before discontinued operations here was 120,000. So 120,000. And my average shares outstanding was 10,000. So my earnings per share is going to be my net income here, okay, divided by this, or B, and that A divided by B is going to be giving me here my earnings per share. Okay. So this here is going to be $12, and the next one here is going to be my discontinued operations. This here was 32,000. Okay. My average shares outstanding is still the same. And so I'm now showing this over here in terms of my earnings per share. This will be roughly about $3.20. And then over here, I'm gonna get my net income of 88,000. And then I'm gonna be dividing this one through here. And that's where I'm gonna get that number from. So it's really important that when we're showing earnings per share, that we're showing, hey, this is essentially before any type of discontinued operations or net income, that we can actually, probably the better way, after tax from continuing operations. Less the amount of the loss on discontinued operations, it's going to be giving me my net income. Remember, I have to show this separately because this is my continuing operations. If I'm showing this year over year, it's absolutely critical for me that I need to be able to go through and say, hey, I've got to tell the reader, hey, don't, this is a separate item, this is a separate deal. This is our continuing operations, and this is what this looks like. So that is exercise 4-8. Thank you so much for joining me here today. Don't forget to like and subscribe. And thank you again for watching Intermediate Accounting After Dark, or the illegal unpublished bootleg tapes. Have a great one.